This is the BBC Home Service. We present Viscountess Genevieve Sellers, Dowager Gladys Seacombe, and Lady Minnie Milligan in
The Dawn Show!
Britain has always been famous for her high standard of education, and every effort is being made to maintain this standard. As the Minister of Education remarked only the other day...
Yup, I'm all for that learning stuff. A, B, L, Q, Z, 2 and 1. Oh, yeah.
To prove this, the goons open to you the gates of England's oldest school, Rotting Dean.
Yes, Rotting Dean. This ancient school was built in the 16th century by its founder, the Dean of Merdle, whose body lies buried in the grounds. Hence the name Rotting Dean.
In the classrooms, the old oaken desks have carved on them names of pupils who have long since become famous. Names like
Crippin,
Jack the Ripper,
Geraldo.
Dr. Arnold Fringe, the brave headmaster who lost his life in the school fire. Heroically, he dashed through the flames into his study, picked up the phone, and was last heard saying...
Hello, hello. Credential? I want to take out a fire insurance. That's from yesterday.
The school has ideal accommodation for its boarders. 100 luxurious bedrooms, one boy per bedroom.
And the other 500 sleep on the floor.
In the great yard, there are the school stables.
Another 700 kept down there.
Sleeping in the stables has, of course, fostered a love of riding, as the headmaster of riding will testify.
Aye, I will, that. Every morning, 230 lads get astride their saddles and gallop over the downs. It's an amazing sight.
Amazing? Why?
We haven't got any horses.
Of course, all is not play. Let us take a look at the arithmetic class where Mr. Seacombe is teaching.
Now, James, let's see what you've got. 2, 7, 3, 8, 9. Mm-hmm. And you, Westing, let's see. 10, 7, 3, 2, 4. Hmm. Well, I've got 3 queens, Jack 10, so you've both had it.
In a modern school like Rotting Dean, the use of the cane as punishment has, of course, been done away with. Oh, yes, yes. The pupil is simply made to put on the dunce's cap, stand with his back to the wall, and...
Take aim! Fire! Oh!
The school... It has a magnificent carpenter shop where the woodwork classes are held.
Now, lads, the next thing is to place the 2 pieces of wood in a vise. Now, you there, what is the best type of vise?
Women.
No, no, the best type of carpenter's vise.
Carpenter's women.
Good lads.
Thank you.
The school is equipped with a very fine gymnasium, and many of the boys are keen gymnasts. You can see them any day, swinging on the trapezes high up near the ceiling. This is not as dangerous as it sounds, for should a boy fall, he lands on the safety net, which is carefully laid out on the concrete floor.
Rotting Dean is co-educational, and as in any other mixed school, little boy and girl romances tend to spring up. Always, however, under the benevolent eye of the headmaster.
Now, Smith, how old are you, lad?
12, sir.
Well, I've heard about your little romance. In this case, I can't really say that I approve, lad.
Oh, but, sir, all the other boys go out with members of the opposite sex, sir.
Yes, yes, but not with my wife!
The school is a fine tradition for sport, and the pupils are almost fanatically persistent in their pursuit of it.
No, you mustn't.
Oh, go on, be a sport.
No,
go on.
No.
And in times of danger, the masters of Rotting Dean were the first to don uniforms. And in moments of great danger, faced by overwhelming odds, would heroically cry the old school motto.
We surrender, don't you? We surrender!
Introducing Max Gilray. Ladies and gentlemen, as you stand before your bathroom mirror in the morning, brushing those pearly white teeth, do you ever stop to consider where that tasty, hygienic toothpaste comes from?
Do you ever think of the men who are slaving underground in the deep shafts of the toothpaste mine, hacking out the crude toothpaste ore with pick and shovel? You don't?
Then beware. A world shortage is threatened. At this very moment, two expeditions are searching for fresh deposits of toothpaste. The first, under Commander Burke, has gone to investigate a report that a rich load lies beneath the sands of the Sahara.
What's our location on the map?
Just nearing the center of the Sahara Desert.
The middle of the Sahara, eh?
Yes.
You're sure we haven't come too far north?
No, darling.
Right. Well, we'll... we'll make camp here. Tell the porters to clear a place in the snow and build igloos.
Right, darling.
And they better make holes in the ice for fishing.
Yes.
I've never known it so cold in the Sahara before.
Commander, sir?
Yes, Jewel?
I believe you're right, sir. We're not in the Sahara at all. We're on the ice caps near the North Pole.
The North Pole?
Yes.
That means we're 24,000 miles off our course.
Good.
However did that happen?
I think our compass was faulty.